Hi everyone and welcome back to my channel. I hope you're all doing well. So today's video is going to be one that is requested quite a lot and it's our meal plan for the week and a food haul. I've done videos like this before in the past and I'll link them all below. But I'm going to share with you today what our meal plan is for the week and I'm also due a food shopping delivery in the next 10 minutes or so. So once it arrives, I'll show you everything that we've got for the week as well. With every food haul that I do, I always plug a video that I did a wee while ago because I think it's really useful for saving money on your shopping. I'm going to leave it linked below. I think it's 10 ways to save money on your food shopping and it really does make a big difference. So yeah, as I said, I'll leave that video linked below alongside all the other food hauls that I've done. But first of all, before my food shopping arrives, I'm going to show you our meal plan for the week. This is, we go Monday to Thursday, Friday really, which I know isn't for the full week, but we never plan our meals on a Saturday or Sunday because it just depends what we're doing. Also, I feel a bit funny about ordering food on a Monday, especially if it's meat and things, and then eating it on a Saturday or a Sunday. It just freaks me out a bit. So we don't tend to plan. Sometimes we'll have like frozen food on a Saturday or Sunday, and sometimes we'll get like a takeaway, or we'll go to like the shops or something during the day and get something for dinner. But this is our plan Monday to Thursday for this week. Let me show you. So this is my plan for the week. So I've been doing a much more relaxed version of my meal plan instead of doing every meal because I never stick to it. What I tend to do is dinners because I feel like they're the things that you need to plan. And then lunches, I'll just put a few ideas to make sure that we've got things in so that we can just do whatever we want that day. And then this is just things that I always miss off the list. For meal plan for dinners, that's what I always start with. This week we are having tomato and chorizo risotto tonight. So that is a gusto recipe. I actually made this in a vlog a couple of weeks ago for the first time and it was really, really good. The only problem with this was that I made it with the normal arborio rice or however you pronounce it and it took ages. But we actually have some frozen risotto rice that you get from Iceland that we've used a couple of times just with another risotto and it's been just as good. So I'm going to try and make it tonight with the frozen risotto and see if it can be a quick meal as well as one that you have to stir for like 45 minutes. Tuesday I'm working tomorrow, so I've just got a quick dinner. I've wrote chicken, but it's actually chicken goujons, mashed potato and veg. We always tend to have something really, really quick during the week because I get in at 5, pick Oliver up, he's already had his dinner, and then by the time we get home and everything like that, it's like 5:45 and we're starving. So Tuesday and Wednesday dinners are always quick. So Wednesday, I put another chorizo one just because I know we'll have some left over from tonight. So this is the chorizo and lemon pasta, but it's actually like linguine. Another gusto recipe that I've been loving recently, I'll leave it linked below. It's so, so easy to make and I'm obsessed with chorizo just now. Definitely recommend that one. Thursday, I'm off. So I've got a bit of, well, this isn't really a longer dinner to make, but I've got sausages, mash and gravy. It's my favourite thing to have in the autumn and because I'm off during the day on Thursday, I'm going to go to the butchers and get the sausages. So we're going to have sausages, I like to have onions and then mashed potato and gravy. Friday, I've not wrote anything down because I think Andy's going out on Friday night, I can't really remember. Whatever we do, we'll end up getting something at the end of the week for the weekend. For lunches, I just wrote stuff for sandwiches, so sandwiches in general. Obviously, I'll just buy bread and cucumber and ham and things like that. Baked potatoes, I get the frozen ones from McCain, I think it is, just because they're just really simple to have and good for Oliver as well. Eggs, we have eggs quite a lot at lunchtime. And then I've just added some fruit that I'll often put in for Oliver's lunch and that I can take to work with me as well. And then on my don't forget list, I just have whole milk because for some reason I've missed that off the list last week. Sandwich bags, because that's something that you don't order all the time and I always forget. And oat bars because I have been so, so hungry recently and I know the Stoat apple and cinnamon ones, I think they are, like they really fill you up. So I had to remember to get them. So I actually managed to pick up some of this stuff yesterday when we went to the co-op, but most of it is coming between 2 and 3 today. I ordered from Tesco. We have done for a good few months now and I find the Tesco website the easiest for like doing an online shop. So I'm just going to get some stuff done and when the shopping arrives I will show you what we got. Okay, so my shopping has arrived. I'm going to start off by showing you what we got from like the cleaning section and toiletries. So I picked up the Clean and Clear Deep Action Cream Wash. This is one that I've used for years and years and it's just amazing. It's actually not as harsh on your skin as people say that Clean and Clear is. I just use this in Nivea cream on my skin and I use micellar water to take my makeup off and it's always been great. I also got this window kit. I thought this might have been
Buddy that Mrs. Hinge talks about, but I don't actually think it is. It's the window kit, but I'm sure I'll use this anyway. I also got Oliver some new toothpaste. This is the one that he always uses. I got him some hair and body wash. I'm going to put this and use it as like a bath foam as well. The Child's Farm stuff is all really nice and it's good for his skin. He has a little bit of eczema. Never been like diagnosed, but I can see that he's got it and Andy's got it, and I'm assuming that it's the same thing that they've both got. So yeah. Really looking forward to using this, and it smells so good as well. I've tried it already. I also got some more Method Wild Rhubarb. I've not had this in a few weeks, or probably longer than that actually, and I really really miss it. I love the smell of the rhubarb one. Saw a new Zaflora. I didn't even know that they sold Zaflora in Tesco, but glad I picked that up because I always use the Linen Fresh, and yeah, at least I've got another one now. I also got some soda crystals. I've not tried this, another Mrs. Hinge thing. So is this. Soda crystals are meant to be good for cleaning your sink like plug holes. So I'm going to try that. I think I need white vinegar as well, which I don't think I have. But yeah, I'll try that out. Got the toilet cleaner, the Duck Pine one, because Mrs. Hinge keeps saying it smells amazing. And if someone tells you something smells good that many times, you just have to try it. Got my sandwich bags, didn't forget them. I got Oliver some Palm Bears. These are his favourite crisps just now. And gravy to have with our sausages and mash. That's like the ultimate cosy dinner when it's like autumn or winter. And I got some Weetabix again for Oliver's breakfast. I got his 50-50 bread, which we always get. And I got some ginger green tea because I heard this can be good for like indigestion and heartburn, which I have been getting a lot in this pregnancy already. And I also got my apple and cinnamon porridge oat bars. Now, moving on to this section, I got a new supply of fusilli pasta, some spaghetti. I've noticed this hearty food company have been in Tesco everywhere just now, and they made little mini pizzas that we really enjoyed. So I think this is quite a good brand. Let me know if anyone else has tried it. Not tried their spaghetti before, but it was the cheapest one. Also got Oliver this little chicken risotto. I usually just have at least one of these in our cupboards for during the week in case anything comes up. Got us some crumpets. These are probably more for me snacking in the night, not during the night. I'm not a midnight snacker, but like a supper kind of thing. And also Oliver has started having bread and butter or a supper before he goes to bed now with his milk, so these will be quite good for that, although they probably won't last that long. We've got some Tesco's Spanish chorizo. That's for our dinners. And some chicken. I actually got this chicken so that we have the option of doing Irocco, which is a different kind of pasta, on Wednesday, because I had got the stuff for the lemon and chorizo one. I got this just in case I wanted to switch it up. I don't know if I've shared that recipe before, and it's not online. I'll let you know on Instagram if I do that on Wednesday, so follow me on Instagram and I'll share the recipe if we do make that on Wednesday. Next, I just got some Petiflu yogurts for Oliver and me because of the heartburn, and some Munch Bunch ones as well. We got these on holiday, although I'm pretty sure these are really high in sugar. Let's check. Per pot, there is 10 grams of sugar, surely not. Okay, these might be just be for me then. And we got some Parmesan for our pasta, some halloumi because I have been craving it so much recently. And I always thought you weren't allowed halloumi when you were pregnant, but I've read online that as long as it's pasteurised, then it's fine. So I'm looking forward to having this. I like it with tomato rice and pineapple. It's just a weird combination, but it was a recipe I got from HelloFresh and I use it for lunchtimes and it's really, really nice. Next, I just got my jacket potatoes for the freezer. The mashed potato, I just went for the lazy option because the plan is to have this after work. So that will be good to have with chicken goujons, again from the Hearty Food Co. That's my favourite dinner just now. I'm sorry if it's such a kid's dinner, but that's what I love. It's not even for Oliver, that's just what we like. And then for Thursday night's dinner, I've got proper potatoes so that I can make the mash. Got us some ham for sandwiches, some sweet corn because Oliver tried this recently and loves corn in the cob, so need to remember and make that for him. And then some other little veg just to have when we have our chicken and mash. I love these wee things. I always forget to buy them. Oliver will have these as well. I'm sure he'll like them. Again, for Oliver, we've got some grapes, some cream for the pasta. This should have been over here. Some bananas, which will not be ready for a couple of days. I hate when they do this. Some chilies. That's what we'll put in to our... if we make Irocco pasta on Wednesday, then that's what we'll use. I got some thyme, which I'll need for my risotto tonight. Cherry tomatoes for the risotto. Cucumber for sandwiches. Red onion for risotto. Oh no, it's not for risotto, that's for pasta. And some pears and some spring onions for risotto.
So I've had to switch to filming on my phone because my lens is all steamed up just now. But I hope you've enjoyed watching this video. I'll leave links to all the other videos below that I've done like this. I hope you enjoyed it. If you did, give it a thumbs up. Don't forget to subscribe and I will see you in my next video. Bye!